with us, three-time world heavyweight champion, the American Dream, Dusty Rhodes, to help us commentate over this match. And Dusty, it's going to be a classic event, I'm sure.
Well, I'll tell you what, the excitement around an event like this, this is the premier event in sports. The world's heavyweight title, Ric Flair, Barry Windham, Nikita Koloff, myself, many of us want this shot. Would love to have this shot right here. Barry Windham gets the shot today. It's going to be a classic event, and I'm just real anxious for it to get started. The people are buzzing, we're buzzing, and the whole wrestling world's buzzing about Nature Boy Ric Flair, the world's heavyweight title. And, you know, from what I hear now, there wants to be another horseman that comes into to play in this thing.
Gentlemen, a man that was voted Rookie of the Year. When they say the sophomore jinx would hit someone, it didn't hit him. He kept on. He continued to become one of the greatest wrestling stars ever. Ladies and gentlemen, Tony, it's a pleasure for me, on behalf of Jim Crockett Promotion, to introduce you to Lex Luger. Lex, good to see you.
Well, thank you very much. You know, all these allocades are true, but the big belt up really isn't necessary because of the fact that unless somebody's had their head in the sand the last year and a half, Lex Luger's been plastered in every magazine cover, every poster, and there's a reason for that. Lex Luger is the total package. Physically, there's a lot of strong guys in sport professional wrestling. I've got that. I'm also intellectually a college graduate. I can do all that. And also, what I have to say is that I'm here for one reason. Because when I put out the word from Florida that I was leaving, promoters got down on their hands and knees and begged Lex Luger, please, Lex Luger, come wrestle for me. They blank checks. Jim Crockett Promotions, that's where the best wrestler is. To be the best, you gotta beat the best, and that's what I'm here for. And also, the financial aspects are here, and that's what I'm interested in. And because of that reason, there's an elite group. I do my homework, I've done my research. And this elite group is named the Horsemen, and that's what I'm gonna be. Thank you.
He said he was gonna be a horseman. Okay, he wants to be a horseman, Dusty, and he's a big man, I tell you what.
I think everybody wants to be a horseman because one of the four horsemen, being one of the four horsemen means money, prestige, and a lifestyle of the rich and famous. But I believe Lex Luger, the superstar that he is throughout this country, that's going to find out that some men such as Nikita Koloff, Dusty Rhodes, the American Dream, Ronnie Garvin, Brad Armstrong, the Rock and Roll Express, going to take care of business. This match here has got me excited. It's going to be a big one today.
And, of course, like we said, for the World Heavyweight title. What an event. Promoters from all over the world are here. Gary Juster is here from up in Baltimore. Carl Elliott Murnick are here with us from Raleigh. And, of course, Mr. Jim Crockett Jr. is here today with us for this big event. Ric Flair, Barry Windham for the World Heavyweight title. Now, Bob Cotto, we understand, is in the dressing room of Mr. Jim Crockett Jr. along with another man who'd like to get his hands on Nature Boy Ric Flair, one half of the superpowers. We're talking about Nikita Koloff. Let's go to Bob Cotto with Mr. Crockett and Nikita Koloff in the dressing room.
Fans, we're in the dressing room of Barry Windham with promoter Jim Crockett and Nikita Koloff. Jim, first of all, congratulations on this great event.
Thank you, Bob. We at Jim Crockett Promotions are very proud of our television program, Worldwide Wrestling, and very proud of the great fans that we have, and it is a great privilege to have Ric Flair defend the title against such a worthy opponent as Barry Windham.
Jim, I know you're proud and you have every right to be, and this man right here who has a lot at stake, I think, in this match, really.
Oh, to say, Mr. Crockett, it is a pleasure to be here to watch this match with you. I only wish it were me who signed the contract against this Ric Flair, for I have come so close to defeating Ric Flair. In my heart, I feel I did defeat Ric Flair, but because of, how do you say, circumstance, they award the belt back to him. Barry Windham, you are a great athlete. I wish good luck to you today in this match. I'd like to say, if you should win, I hope you know I expect to meet you in the ring. Ric Flair, if you should win, I will meet you in the ring.
All right, fans, right now back to ringside.
Okay, Bob, thank you very much. Dusty, the excitement is building, but now let's talk about what led up really to this. And really, you can say maybe that Barry Windham pushed him into a corner because what happened right here last week on TV?
Well, Tony, I don't know if he pushed him in the corner. What happened on television was that a few weeks ago, the Four Horsemen jumped on Barry Windham. Barry Windham came out in a match with Denny Brown, and just to see how it was, Ric Flair were there, the Horsemen were there. Me and the Rock and Roll Express came down. It turned into be one of the greatest 8 minutes I've ever seen, and it was fast and furious, and Barry Windham really made a point of saying to the world, to the nation, and to the wrestling fraternity, if you will, I am world championship caliber I am, what's going on today. We take a look at that thing right now because it is a tremendous piece that's led up to what this match is all about.
Okay, here it is. Ric Flair, Barry Windham, two great athletes, and Dusty, the Four Horsemen, are always around. So you came down along with the Rock and Roll Express.
Well, this thing, this incident, they had already gotten into it. The Four Horsemen were out there. Iron Anderson, Tully Blanchard, J.J. Dillon, Ole Anderson, always somewhere around. Dusty Rhodes came down the Rock and Roll Express. We just made it even. This was a lumberjack match. We made it even. We made it a lumberjack match to make sure nobody interfered. You see right here, Barry Windham is in full control of Ric Flair. Both men, I mean, they went at it as hard as you're going to go at it right here. Ric Flair turns the tide of this thing. Wasn't even a match, so we're calling it a match. It was not a scheduled match, but it turned into be a shot heard around the world, a shot heard throughout this country that made a statement, if you will, like I make a statement, like Nikita Koloff, Ronnie Garvin, Wahoo McDaniel, Brad Armstrong, all made a statement. You've got to beat the man to be the man. Ric Flair is the man. I beat the man three times World Heavyweight Champion. Ric Flair is now facing today, right here, the most stern test of this last 24 hours, baby, because he wakes up in the morning looking for it, and we're coming after him.
Okay, as you see right now, Flair throwing Windham down on the floor. There's no doubt about it, when you face Ric Flair, you know to face Ric Flair, you got to be in top physical condition.
Well, you got to be in top physical condition. You got to have your mental attitude ready. Right here, you see Barry Windham come up from the pain that he was in, a big slam on the Nature Boy Ric Flair, and right here, one of the patented moves of Barry Windham. Maybe today we'll see this. Maybe today we'll see him win the World Heavyweight title with this move right here. The drop kick, right there, Ric Flair down for the count, the referee, but Ric Flair got a lot of staying power. He knows what it's all about. It's his belt. You've got to beat him. He's playing defense. He's playing defense. You got to play offense. You got to beat Ric Flair to be World Heavyweight Champion.
Right now, there's the flying lariat. Barry Windham covers the man, and then mayhem breaks out in the ring. And Dusty, we're getting ready for a great event, just a taste of what we're going to see.
Well, I'm ready, and thousands of fans in this packed arena and throughout this country are ready for this World